to increase your chances of getting that letter of support from a designated organization. There is now tremendous competition for the limited number of startup visa letters of support from designated organizations within the space of the startup visa program, with some designated organizations even charging in excess of $500,000 just for a single letter of support. So, how can you increase your chances of success of getting that coveted letter of support from a DO? I'm Andrea Bailey from Yala, Canada. I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant and the only one that's moved to Canada on the startup visa program herself. And that is why I have the insights that come from both being an immigration consultant and being a founder member as well. So let's take a look at what matters and what's important within a startup visa application. Number one, your business concept matters. The importance of an innovative concept cannot be underestimated. This will serve as the starting point in the evaluation of your application. Now, do be careful that you do not purchase a business concept or a business plan that you don't fully understand. It is very simple and easy for a DO, that is a designated organization, to actually tell when a founder does not truly understand his own business when they interview you for your acceptance into the program. Number two, your founding team matters. The background and the pedigree of the founding team is crucially important in the success of your startup. Even though the startup visa program has low benchmarks for language, work experience, and education, you do not want to have a team that does not appear to be qualified. Select co-founders that work with you, share the same values, and complement each other. Number three, the quality of your application matters. Make sure your application is professionally written. Even if you understand your own business plan well, it is good practice to have a professional business writer to actually draft your pitch deck and your business plan. This professional writer would also be able to add on the nuances that the IRCC will expect to see from an immigration viewpoint. These days, most designated organizations require you to have a full-fledged written business plan submitted in advance as part of your initial application process. It is not like earlier when formal business plans could be written at a later point in time. Number four, have your MVP ready. It is now typically not sufficient to just have an idea stage startup any longer. The expectation is that you have a minimum viable product ready to go. This demonstrates that you are not just armed with a PowerPoint presentation, but actually have a product that you have invested in developing. Some designated organizations will specifically ask you to share your technology readiness in terms of your startup's position on the TRL scale. In general, you would be expected to be at a TRL 7, 8, or 9, which demonstrates that you have a product already built and ready to go to market. Number five, startups with revenues are preferred. If your startup already has product market fit, customers, and revenue, you stand a better chance of qualifying for that coveted letter of support. And a genuine startup with this kind of traction also makes it possible to access designated organizations who might charge a lower fee. Of course, having a startup with revenues is not always a possibility, and you need to make the most of the concept and the traction that you and your team have. Number six, utilize a good consultant with relationships to multiple designated organizations. Not all designated organizations charge a fee of $500,000. Now, if you are a genuine startup, you might be able to access letters of support for a lower price. And a good consultant would be able to step in and help you secure that letter of support without paying an exorbitant fee. Also, do keep in mind that the letter of support, while important, is only really the start of your journey. So, be careful or wary when a consultant asks you to budget $100,000 per founder for the letter of support fee, but does not advise you to invest adequate funds into your business to actually grow and operate your business. Having said that, The new normal is that letters of support come at a higher price and you need to be prepared to pay the fee to be able to access the limited supply. This is Andrea from Yala Canada. Thank you for watching. If you want more insights on how you can qualify for Canada Startup Visa Program, reach out to me or my team. Our details are in the description.